This is the first time this has ever been recorded and shown publicly. We recently toured the largest HVAC factory in North America, and in this video, we are going to go even further by showing you more footage of the Daikin Fit assembly line. You can see the first video in our YouTube playlist called Daikin Texas Technology Park Trip. But for this video, we will show you the Daikin Fit assembly line located right here in the USA. This was the first time this assembly line has ever been recorded, and some of the things we saw can't even be shared publicly since the proprietary technology we saw is what sets Daikin apart from the competition. We will also show you interviews with some of the individuals making it all happen. So let's get started. So what's the big deal? Why should you even care? We've done other videos about the Daikin Fit, all the advantages it has over many of the other options out there when you're trying to heat and cool your home. And we also did a video recently where we talked about some of the new products coming out revolving around the Daikin Fit. But I thought it would be cool to do this video in particular to show you not only is it made here in America, and not only that this assembly line has never been recorded by anyone before, but I thought showing you just a snapshot of something that homeowners never get to see. All they see is the end product. I wanted you to see who's behind it, what they're doing, and let you actually see it being made. And to go even further, here's Arvind.
So what you see behind me is the latest investment Daikin made here in Waller, Texas. This used to be a warehouse, 140,000 square feet of warehouse, which we really converted into a manufacturing area. So it's not just a final assembly line. We've got a very vertically integrated setup over here with the sub-assemblies, with all the base bands, the PCBs, the copper coil, copper tubing, sheet metal, and the entire assembly line goes over here.
They're built from the ground up.
It was built from the ground up. And we had a lot of collaboration between Thailand, Japan, and the engineers here locally. Really proud of the effort here. We had a cool team, about 50 people. They've dedicated about 2.5 years of their time working through the global pandemic, the global supply chain shortages, and really launching this product at a record pace between 18 months. This is not just an assembly line or final assembly line. What we call this is a focus factory or a fit factory within this overall DTTP factory. So we start out in our sub-assembly areas, we stamp our metal over here. The assembly and the sub-assembly is done right here at Houston. We are actually making our tubing, making our coils, the sheet metal and the PCBs, they get assembled right over here. What I'm really proud of this team is really putting in the process innovation in there. The line that you got to see today, Josh, it's state of the art, one of the best of the best. It can compete with any competitor, any region of the world. And it's got a lot of robotics, a lot of automation. You saw AGVs. We have done a lot of Daikin first, you know, some of the processes that we have put in to track parts, match parts, all with the consumer and the operator in mind, so that we build quality first time around, so there's less rework. And of course, at the end of the day, we want to make sure a good quality product goes out the door.
Do you guys watch YouTube?
Yes.
This is gonna probably be on YouTube, so look for this fat face.
You worked at the Daikin in Japan, right?
Yes.
And so y'all perfected it, figured out all the secrets, and then brought it here. So everything that's being manufactured here is top notch. Can you talk a little bit about that and some of the things that, you know, I know there are certain things we're not allowed to disclose, but some of the things that you're doing here to, with the robotic side of things, to make the product as great as possible.
Okay. So we have to realize that this, we call the module concept. It's where to design the Daikin Japan for the standardized the process system. Based on the our previously, the most advanced the production line in Japan, based on this line, we still advanced to added some of the automation. We call the grow metal insertion, the compressor loading, and the coil loading, also the deep robotics. We advanced based on the previous advanced line. We realized for the this line. We installed the automating the leak test system using the robot. Then we can tell him with a small demonstrate so we can catch up the fine leaks. And also, we are using the robot system, we can catch up the 100% of leaks, close to the 100% leaks for the this leak test system.
We have some automated technologies that directly tells the suppliers what we need, and it comes directly to the point of use to the assembly line. There are some technologies we have, I mean, you name the technology and it is there that we are using. Some systems, we are improving some signals that will tell the forklift driver exactly what time to bring and when to bring. That is very important.
And you built all this?
Yes, we installed this. It was a fun project, definitely.
And not done?
Not done. We continue to improve. You need to add automation process. I love it.
Anything you would want to tell somebody that's buying this?
I have a Daikin at home.
Yeah. Let me say that again.
I have a Daikin at home.
Okay.
We definitely care about the quality. That's one of our biggest things. We do a lot of effect checks, so we're not letting anything go out the door that isn't right. So I definitely take pride in that, and I have to do it myself. So I would definitely recommend it.
Two messages that we would like to hit on. One is, you know, from a consumer lens, right? And also workers, the ergonomics.
First question, what is ergonomics?
Great question. Who wants to answer that?
It's basically designing the work around the worker. Make sure they don't have reach, they don't have bend, they don't have turn, they don't have walk. So what you're gonna see over there is just that, how have they designed the station around the worker, so the worker, all they have to do is pick and place and assemble. They want to make sure you're making the work as easy as possible, as safe as possible, so that we don't have, and safety's first. I mean, that's why we picked
up. You're a good boss, Arvind. You're a good boss. I have never had a boss say they want to make my job easier. I think
the people who build this product, one of the big difference between the competition and Daikin is we bring in our customers for a tour. No company will do that unless they are confident and have the confidence in the people and the quality and the workmanship that we're putting together. Nobody is going to take that huge effort or even the risk to bring in people.
Yeah.
So for me, I think it's quality, but tied up with the PCM portion of it. There's a lot of effort that goes in building it. And if we don't build a quality product, then we don't exist.
Well, that's it, guys. I had such a great time making this video. One thing I'll say is if you're comparing the Daikin Fit to another product, the thing I took out of this whole experience is I now have seen where it's made. I don't have to wonder about where it's being imported from. I've actually seen the people that are making it firsthand, and now you have too. Thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button. We'll see you next time.